Let's see. Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me? Yes, check. So technology is also very good and very helpful. What we're going to do today, today's a challenge day. And so the challenge essentially is to meditate without my guidance, which is, of course, sort of the end goal, but also to nurture sort of like a high quality experience without my guidance. Meditation isn't supposed to be anything, but this starts to lead into the flow state conversation. But when meditation is sort of like a good meditation, and usually what people mean by that is it was sort of euphoric physically, or it was enchanting mentally in the sense of losing a sense of time or losing a sense of self, or it was uplifting emotionally, so there was a surge in positive affect. That's usually what people mean by I had a nice meditation. And those consequences or experiences are correlated to like you doing it right or wrong. And so this sort of goes against mindfulness in a little bit, in small ways. But essentially what you want to do is you really want to be committed, right? Back to this concept of right effort. Even when you're practicing, there should be this like, you know, very virtuous, noble, sincere will within your doing or non-doing, whatever it really is. And so you must strike the bell of joy. Like every breath, you have that capacity to do that. It's a choice. It exists underneath what we are in control of. And so you must strike the bell of joy with as many breaths as possible. While being openly aware and monitoring the situation without specific intent. And if you can do that, if you can hit that bell or cast that joy inside yourself consistently, it leads to a deeper experience. And that deeper experience proves that your brain was put into another mode, like a physical gear. And that is what meditation is. Whether we talk about it or not, whether a lineage proclaims there is a goal or there is no goal, there is a physical goal. Cool. So the challenge is you're going to do this all on your own. Another challenge, I'm at Aurora Airport in Guatemala City. You can do this anywhere. So go meditate in public. Super fun to like cast your zone of peace and hear the buzz of other people sort of operating in a different state of mind. That contrast really gives you a sense of, oh, I am actually doing something pretty cool, pretty different when I meditate, when I just choose to be openly aware of the present moment on purpose, non-judgmentally. Sweet. Alrighty, so I think we got a solid 26 minutes. You must cast or strike the bell of joy. Alrighty, comfortable position, eyes closed. Whether the teachings proclaim there is no goal or there is, biologically there is a consequence. And the intensity of that consequence determines the impact of the practice. And so while you don't have to strike the bell of joy to be mindful, it is better to. That is the right effort. Choose what is uplifting. Choose what is also beautiful. Alrighty. You are on your own.
behind you.
Thank you.
Slow down the breath. Notice you are paying attention to the present moment on purpose, non-judgmentally. Notice how the effort of doing this is a dynamic experience. Moments of palpable openness and interconnection. And then moments of fixation. Our awareness dilates, it ebbs and flows. But that's part of the moment. The consequence of this effort mainly is intimacy between self and now. And from intimacy, insight. One of the great insights of mindfulness is there is always a reason to be joyous. There is always a pearl of joy somewhere. The breath is a steadfast resource of joy. Three more breaths. Commit to your mental attitude. Cultivate open awareness. Three more breaths. Last breath, a refresher of yesterday's message. Trust that your ears are hearing on their own, your mind is thinking on its own, the world is happening on its own. All right, breath in, open the eyes. Good work, everyone.